welcome back to another episode of Smarty Pants. So we're in a different part of the garden today. You might notice that there are no tulips all around me. So before we start talking about butterflies, I wanted to show you guys a different part of the garden. So my roommate, I will call her Farmer Nikki, has been working on preparing the vegetable food portion of the garden. And you can see that there is different ways that you prepare the food. So over here, we have this rounded trellis, and that's where the tomatoes are going to grow. So the tomatoes will grow up a vine and onto this bush, and they'll start growing onto that trellis, and that's what's going to help them stabilize. And then over here, you'll see that she started making these kind of triangular pyramids. And you'll see the sticks in the back. So those long sticks are going to indicate where the different vegetables are. So she's going to replace those with smaller sticks that have the names of each vegetable on them. So some of them will say peppers and things like that. But these teepees right here, that's going to help the cucumbers and the peas so they can grow up where that piece of cardboard is. So once she's ready to transplant those vegetables, then they'll start growing up there. So back to reality, we're talking about butterflies. And the week before that, we were talking about the bees. Once all of the vegetables and the other flowers, like sunflowers, the daisies, start growing in this garden, we're gonna see a lot more of those butterflies and those bees. So a lot of times these two creatures, you see them working together because they're both pollinators. They both collect pollen on their legs and bring them from flower to flower, which helps the flowers grow. We learned that about the bees. They both suck up nectar with their long tongues. Right? And the bees bring the nectar back to the hive to make honey. The butterflies drink the nectar, that's some of their food. But they also have different similarities aside from just drinking nectar and pollen. The way their bodies are shaped and formed are also very similar. They have thorax, they have an abdomen, wings, antenna. So I have a picture, a little video picture clip for us to take a look at so we can see more of those similarities. And then we'll get into the important part of the butterfly's wings so we can learn more about that. So let's take a look at this clip and then I'll see you back in the garden. The butterfly and the bumblebee. At first glance, when you look at these two friends, they look pretty different. But the parts of their body that make them who they are more similar than you think. For starters, they both have antennae. And this middle portion of their body, a thorax. Connected to that thorax for both the butterfly and the bee are their wings. And the next section of their body, the abdomen. You'll see that on the butterfly, it's kind of hidden behind his wings. He has this round end to his body, like that of the bumblebee, the abdomen. Both of these creatures shaped differently, do different things, but at the end of the day, they're all a part of a similar family that gives them similar body parts. But they do use them a bit differently. Let's head back to the garden and learn more.
All right, welcome back. So, now that we've seen how similar their body parts are, I want to talk more about the wings. Bees' wings, they fly so fast. We talked about that a couple weeks ago. So the reason, or I should say, the purpose of their wings are very different from the purpose of
a butterfly's wings. Butterflies, their wings are colorful for a reason. It's not just to look pretty. It's not just to attract different pollinators, like the flowers, right? Do you remember the flowers are so colorful because the bees and the butterflies are like, ooh, look at those pretty colors. Let's go to those flowers. But that's not the reason the butterflies are so pretty. Their wings are actually there to protect them. So there's three main reasons why their wings are so important. So for starters, some of these colors of their wings are meant to camouflage. So let's say that word again, camouflage. That means they help them hide. Camouflage means to hide, to not be seen, to be hidden. So maybe a butterfly is green, so it can blend in with the leaves. Or maybe there are different shades of red so that it can blend in with a red flower. Now, another reason that the wings are so important is another type of protection called the startle effect. Startle effect. That means that their wings have all of these different patterns to look bigger, to look like big scary animals. So sometimes the wings have big circles on them to look like eyes of another big creature, or a big mouth, big teeth. So they're meant to look scary. Other times, not just to look like big creatures, the wings are there to show that they're poisonous. These colors, they look scary to some other animals. Like, ooh, stay away from the red and the black and the orange ones, because that means poison. That means it will hurt me if I eat it, right? Because some of these animals, like the flies, the frogs, they eat the butterfly. So that's where the camouflage and the startle effect come in. It's to save them, to protect them from the animals that want to eat them. The last important mechanism of protection for these butterflies is called mimicry. So let's say that again. Mimicry. To mimic. To look like something else. So, those animals that have the startle effect and the camouflage, there are some butterflies that can't protect themselves. And their wings will mimic that of another animal. For example, the monarch butterfly, which is the main butterfly we're going to talk about this week. The monarch butterfly, their colors are those black, orange, and whites that I said can be scary, because their wings are poisonous. If another animal eats them, it will hurt them, because there are fluids and liquids and toxins running through their wings, through their veins, that if somebody else eats it, it will hurt their tummy. Have you ever eaten something and it bothered your stomach and you were like, ooh, I don't feel so good? That's what happens when, say, a frog eats a monarch butterfly. But not all butterfly wings are toxic. If you touch it, it won't hurt you. But some butterflies, they wish that their wings were poisonous, because that would keep them safe. Like how in the winter a warm jacket keeps you safe from the cold. Some butterflies don't have that warm jacket to keep them safe from other animals eating them. So they pretend to be the monarch butterfly. Like how you might pretend to be a doctor, or you might pretend to be a chef. These butterflies pretend to be monarch butterflies. So you might see a red, orange, black and white butterfly and you think it's a monarch, but it's not. It's pretending. So, recap. There is the camouflage effect to blend in with the leaves, their surroundings. The startle effect to look like bigger, scarier animals and scare away the animals that want to eat them. And mimicry, Number three, 1, 2, 3, mimicry, to copy and mimic and look like other animals. So let's take a look at a video of these animals, these butterflies doing just that, and see if you can spot when they're doing camouflage, mimicry, or the startle effect. And I'll see you soon. Welcome back. So, were you able to spot mimicry, camouflage, and the startle effect? Did you find it in the video? Good job. So, I talked a little bit about the monarch butterfly and how they're poisonous and they can make other animals' bellies hurt if they eat them. So I want to talk more about the monarch butterfly and how that happened to them, how they became these toxic, poisonous animals. So, now if you remember from last week, we talked about the life cycle of the butterfly, how they started off as eggs, became caterpillars, turned into cocoons, and then became butterflies. We're going to talk more about that first step, the eggs. So the butterfly, like a bird, lays eggs. But a bird lays their eggs in a nest. Butterflies lay their eggs on leaves, specifically milkweed leaves. Those leaves are poisonous. So if someone was to touch them, they might get a rash. Or if someone was to eat them, it wouldn't be good for their body. So they lay their eggs underneath the milkweed leaf to keep them safe. They're hidden. They're underneath the eggs. And those eggs soak up the toxin from the leaf. And so when the egg hatches into a caterpillar, the toxin is still inside the caterpillar. It's living in its skin. And so the caterpillar is living his life. He's getting bigger. He gets into his cocoon. And then when it breaks free into a butterfly, the toxin is still in there. The toxin is now in its wings. So that's why the monarch butterfly is so magical. It didn't just magically get this poison. It ate it off of the leaf, but it didn't hurt the butterfly. It helped the butterfly. So by putting their eggs on this leaf, that mommy monarch butterfly was saving and helping the future monarch butterflies so that they could protect themselves from the animals that want to eat them. Because animals are smart. They know if they eat something one time and it hurt them, they're not going to eat it again. They're like, ooh, that was a bad experience. I'm not going to do that anymore. So now there's all of these generations of animals that are like, I'm staying away from that monarch butterfly. So this mommy saved their butterflies by just doing one thing, putting them on that milkweed plant. And now all these other butterflies wish they were as cool as the monarch butterfly so that they can protect themselves too. So let's watch one more quick clip of just a monarch butterfly flapping their beautiful wings, and then we're going to get into a project. So I'll see you back in my kitchen for a fun project on butterfly wings. I'll see you soon. Bye.
Really, when I look into your eyes, you're the only one I need. How to describe how lovely you make me feel inside. You give me butterflies, got me flying so high in the sky. Taking control of butterflies. You give me butterflies, got me flying so high in the sky. Taking control of butterflies.
All right, everyone, it's time to get ready for our project of the day. The materials are very simple today, just a few sheets of paper cut in half, some paint, whichever colors you want, and a few paintbrushes to go along with it. And that's all, so let's get started. All right, everyone, let's get ready for our project. Grab your materials and then feel free to pause the video and come on back so we can get started. Okay, we're ready to go. So you're going to take the two pieces of paper, or however many butterfly wings you want to make, and we're going to fold them so they look like this, so that it looks like a book. You can open and close it. So take your piece of paper. Your hands are going to hold the shorter side, so that means the long side is on top. The short side is in your fingers. And we're going to fold it until the two sides kiss. And there's going to be this open piece in the middle, and you're going to pinch it closed. Two hands, pinch it closed. See it on another one. Hold the long side. Make the two sides meet, have them kiss. Now it looks like this, like a weird U. This part right here, pinch in your fingers, pinch in your fingers, close. Parents, your children might need help doing this, but if you want to let them try, go for it, see how it goes. Now I'm going to push the camera down so we can see the painting element. Okay. So as I said, we're making butterfly wings today, and our butterfly wings are going to be inspired by the three different coping or three different mechanisms that the butterflies use to protect themselves from other animals called predators. So those were camouflage, the startle effect, and mimicry. So choose one of those and let's start. So I'm going to take my paint and my paintbrush. And first, I want to make the middle part of the butterfly, the thorax and the abdomen. So I'm going to, down the middle of the paper, draw a black line. This is optional. You can always do this part last. Black line in the middle. Now, when I paint the paper, I'm only going to paint one side. It doesn't matter. It could be this side or this side, but I'm only painting one side. So to help myself remember, I'm going to put my hand on the side I'm not painting. It's now staying there. Or you can take something else and put it on top to help you remember. My hand's there. Now I'm going to paint this side. So maybe I want
to camouflage my butterfly in a green leaf. Maybe I want to add some yellow. Maybe the butterfly is out in the fall when the leaves are turning red. So maybe I'll add some red. And let's see what happens. So we have our blank side and our painted side. So now we're going to close it like a book. Close it, it's closed. And now press. Press, 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 tap, 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 rub, 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 rub. And now we're gonna open it. And there are our wings. They are symmetrical. They are the same on each side because butterflies tend to have symmetrical wings. So we made a symmetrical butterfly, a mirror image. Let's try one more. And then make as many as you want. So you have your piece of paper, you're opening it up. Going to draw my black line to make my thorax and my abdomen. Okay. And now this time, I think this time I want to do the startle effect. I think I'm going to make my butterfly look kind of like maybe a scary animal. So I'm thinking, let's give my butterfly a big black eye. And then maybe it has a bunch of little blue eyes around it. Oh. Maybe I want to give it a big red scary mouth. And maybe I want it to have some big yellow teeth coming out of the mouth to look scary so that the other animals don't eat him. Oh. And then maybe I'll make the background green. The big scary green monster. And let's see what happened. You can also just paint it to look like whatever you want your butterfly to look like. So remember, this side was left white. Now I'm going to fold it like a book. And press, 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 press. And let's open it up. And there are our symmetrical wings. So now it kind of looks like it has two big black eyes and this big crazy mouth. So I think this will definitely scare some frogs and maybe some foxes and other animals away from eating that butterfly. Now I'm going to let those dry. And that's our project. Some other options if you want. Once they dry, moms and dads, you can fold them and cut them to look like actual butterfly wings. So if you want, you can cut them so when you open them up, it looks like wings. And if you cut it folded, it's the same on each side. Make your life easier. All right, now you have a little butterfly. All right, everyone, I hope you enjoyed our project today. Send me pictures of your butterflies so I can see what effect, what mechanism you used, whether it was mimicry, camouflage, or startle. Maybe you made a monarch butterfly. So send me pictures, I'd love to see. And I'll see you next time on SmartyPants. Bye, everyone.